There are so many ways we can cook a food. We can grill, boil, bake, fry, roast, or steam. And while each one of these methods is a bit different, all of them share one thing. They transfer heat or thermal energy. In this video, we'll be talking about the science behind steaming. Take a moment and try to list as many foods as you can that are steamed. Here's just a few that we've come up with. Around the world, different cultures have steamed foods and used various tools to do so. Archaeologists have found artifacts suggesting steaming was going on about 3,000 years ago. Now, it may seem surprising, but compared to other methods, steaming is actually the fastest way to give a boost of heat into our food. So how and why? It's all about phase changes, going from one phase, like liquid, to another, like gas. Now, there are actually two phase changes occurring here that play important roles. So we're going to start with what we think is the potentially more obvious one that's happening here, because it will help us understand the more surprising one that's also occurring. So this first phase change is evaporation, water going from a liquid to a gas, which is what we need in order to steam something. Steam is simply water vapor or water in its gas form. The easiest way to do this is take some water and heat it until it reaches 100 degrees Celsius. We see this when we boil pasta. Now with pasta, steam isn't really our goal, the boiling water is, but they're occurring at the same time. And that's because the water is at 100 degrees Celsius, and so we see both water in its liquid and vapor form as it's evaporating. So while steam is kind of an afterthought when it comes to pasta, for other foods, it's all about the steam. For example, in bread baking, bakers often intentionally create steam in the first moments of baking bread and will go to serious lengths to do so. They might add in water or ice cubes into the oven. By doing this, the surface of the dough goes from room temperature to 90 degrees Celsius in about a minute. This quick burst and change of temperature encourages the gas particles to rapidly expand in the bread, creating a beautiful rise. Without steam, it takes about 4 times as long for the surface temperature to increase. So why is steaming such a fast and powerful way to heat food? We're finally at that sneakier second phase change that's also occurring that we were hinting at earlier, condensation. And if you've ever covered a pot of boiling water before, you've probably noticed it, but maybe weren't really thinking that much about it. However, whenever water vapor or steam is surrounding and cooking food, this process is happening directly on the food itself. So let's take bao, for example, where we have bread dough inside steaming baskets. Now, the moment the steam fills the basket, condensation occurs. We have incredibly hot and energetic water vapor particles surrounding and colliding with the particles on the surface of the much cooler dough, which starts at room temperature about 20 degrees Celsius. So you might be wondering why this matters and why we're making such a big deal about it. It's because during this process of condensation, a gigantic transfer of energy from the water particles to the dough is occurring, way more than if we were just boiling the water or this phase change wasn't occurring. Now, why so much energy? So let's go back to our original scenario of how we produced steam. If we take liquid water and add heat or thermal energy to it, we'll notice that its temperature continues to increase until we get to 100 degrees Celsius, that is. The temperature stays the same despite the fact that we're still adding tons of thermal energy to it. This is because essentially the energy is being used to make the phase change occur. In its liquid form, water particles are held together by attractive forces, also known as intermolecular forces or hydrogen bonding, and those require energy to be overcome. So when the water is actively boiling, some of those particles are gaining enough energy to essentially wiggle free of those attractive forces that keep them together in the liquid. And when they do this, they evaporate and become a gas. Now we can look at this in another way through water's phase change diagram, which shows how water's temperature changes as we add heat. And if you notice here, we'll see that the temperature is increasing while it's in certain phases, but during phase changes, it's flat. And that's because of what we just talked about. Now, something to note here is that this line is quite long, showing us that a ton of energy is needed for evaporation to occur. Now, on the flip side, when we consider condensation, it's at that exact same point, but it's in reverse. We're now thinking about how much energy is being taken out, not added. And so this explains why we see such a large amount of energy being released into the dough the moment the water is condensing from a gas to a liquid. So when comparing steaming to other methods of cooking, we know that the condensation creates a big burst of energy, making it a very efficient way to heat things. Additionally, we don't see any browning occurring like we would with a baked bread. Browning is due to the Maillard reaction and caramelization, which require temperatures of 140 degrees Celsius, which is not possible when using steam that can only reach 100 degrees Celsius. So if we were to experiment and take that same bao and put it in the oven, it would brown because the water would eventually evaporate on the surface of the bao, allowing it to get to temperatures that are above 100 degrees Celsius. Okay, so to be honest, we really only hit the tip of the iceberg when it comes to phase changes, water, and cooking. There are so many other things to explore, like the relationship between pressure and temperature, and the idea that by understanding how water behaves with heat, we can actually understand how many foods behave, because so many foods are made up of water. That's it for today. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Bite Sized. Be sure to like and subscribe for more videos.